What's up, YouTube? This is Thomas from Thomas Invest, and thank you for watching. In this video, we're going to talk about Ready Capital, ticker symbol RC. We're going to check what Ready Capital does and discuss some fundamentals. In the last part, I'm going to talk about the dividends and the stock price, so make sure you watch until the end. And also, please let me know what you think about Ready Capital in the comments. Remember, to always do your own research and never fully trust on what I or other YouTubers say about a stock. I'm not a financial advisor and this content is just for entertaining purposes only. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to get notified when I'm posting a video. I also appreciate an early thumbs up which helps me within the YouTube algorithm. For now, let's dive into it. Okay, what does Ready Capital do? Ready Capital is a multi-strategy real estate finance company that originates, acquires, finance and services small to medium-sized balance commercial loans. In this chart, we see the breakdown of the revenue and the portfolio breakdown as well. Okay, now that we have a sort of clear knowing what RC does, it's time to check the fundamentals of the company. Let's start with the PE ratio. We can calculate the PE ratio by dividing the market cap by the net income. In this chart, we see the history of Ready Capital's PE ratio according to macro trends. Next up is profit margin. We calculate this by dividing net income by total revenue. We want this to be at least 10%. In the case of Ready Capital, it's around 17.3%, which is very nice, of course. In this chart, we do see they have a very solid profit margin over the last years. This is a very good sign for me. The next thing I want to discuss is the revenue growth. In this chart, we do see some big growth in the revenue. Back in 2016, they had 137 million in revenue. In 2020, we are sitting at 259 million in revenue. That's an increase of 89% in the last 5 years. Ready Capital does have an average revenue growth over the last 5 years of 17% annually. This is very nice. Even in 2020, when the Roni virus was there, they managed to grow their revenue year on year by almost 30%. Pretty impressive. Okay, next up is profit growth. You want this number increasing every year. In the case of Ready Capital, this is maybe a first red X. Back in 2016, they were having 49 million in net income. In 2017, we see a little decline. Then an increase in net income in 2018, again in 2019, but in 2020, we do see a decline in revenue again. I don't think this should be considered as a major problem, because we all know the Roni virus kicked in. I'm looking forward to the quarterly results and to check their year-on-year growth. I will definitely make a new video when they release their quarterly results, of course. Another thing to discuss are the shares outstanding. You want this number to be decreasing so you will own more of the company in ratio. For example, if the company has 10 shares outstanding and you own 1 share, you own 10% of the company. If the company issues 5 more shares, they have 15 shares outstanding, but you still only own 1 share, meaning you own 7% of the company. Ready Capital doesn't buy back shares right now. They had a few acquisitions which increased the number of outstanding shares. So, this isn't a big problem for me, but if you do find this a big problem, please make sure to do some research, reading 10Ks for example. Current assets over current liabilities. An incredibly important number for me. This number tells me if the company is able to pay off all current liabilities with the current assets. In this chart, we do see the current assets, current liabilities, and the current ratio as well for Ready Capital in 2020. You want the current ratio to be at least 1.5. But just to be sure, a current ratio of 2.0 is more comfortable for me. But I have to admit, Ready Capital is able to pay off current liabilities by the current assets right now. Now that we have a clear image of how Ready Capital is performing, I want to talk about the dividends and the stock price. Starting off with the dividends. First of all, Ruddy Capital is a REIT. They are typically known having a higher dividend yield most of the time. In the case of Ruddy Capital, we do see a dividend yield of 8.5% according to Seeking Alpha. But the payout ratio is only at 72%, so I'm not worrying if they can pay the dividends in the short term. I don't see Ruddy Capital as a steady dividend payer right now, if we take a look at the dividend history. But to be fair, an 8% dividend yield is maybe a bit too high. In the last part of this video, I want to talk about the stock price. At this moment, Ruddy Capital is trading around $14, which is almost an all-time high, as we can see in this chart. They were falling down big time last year, but ever since the lowest point, around $3, they were climbing all the way up to the all-time high. I started buying Ruddy Capital around $7, so I'm feeling comfortable adding more shares of Ruddy Capital right now. But it has to be said that this company has some pros and cons, as we discussed earlier. So, my conclusion is that I do see some strong indicators in my mini fundamental analysis. Ruddy Capital has a nice PE ratio, hovering at 120. They have a profit margin of 17%, which is very nice, and the revenue is growing at a steady pace, even during the Roni virus. Ruddy Capital also have a current ratio above 1.5, which comforts me. But there are two downsides with this company. The numbers of shares outstanding are increasing every year, and the dividend is maybe too high at this moment, and not very solid if you take a look at the history. But these are strange times, so I will give them the benefit of the doubt in case of the dividends. For me, Ruddy Capital is a buy at this moment, but remember to always do your own research and never fully trust on what I or other YouTubers say about a stock. I'm not a financial advisor, and this content is just for entertaining purposes only. I hoped you liked the video and I did bring some insights of the company to you. I would really appreciate a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel, so you will get notified when I'm posting a new video. For now, thanks for watching and I will see you in my next video.